Everybody's rocking with Chewy on Charlotte's new hip-hop station, Streets 103.3.
Streets 103.3, Charlotte's new hip-hop station. Ladies and gentlemen, I have a special guest in here. Go ahead, let them know who I got with me, homie.
You got Malik Green, CEO of Bottom Dreams Entertainment, coming straight from the bottom, Boulevard Homes.
Hey, Charlotte, stand up.
Mm-hmm, 704, somebody got to do it.
Town come from the west side.
Yeah, west side, West Boulevard, the bottom, Boulevard Homes. I was a peewee running around that little hood, so.
What was life like growing up over there?
Man, we made the best of what we had, man. My mama had 5 kids, 4 girls, 1 boy. I'm the youngest one out of the bunch. So we made the best of what we had. It was a struggle, but we made it through, but that's what made me strong today.
Now today you rapping. What made you get into rapping?
Really, I've been rapping since I was like 10 years old. And my biggest influence is Tupac Shakur. Yeah, I look at him as a big, real big influence on
why our Tupac?
Because he talk about the realest shit. Like,
look, you can't like, be hesitant. He like, I don't know if I want to curse, man.
I mean,
nah, go ahead, man.
Yeah, he talk about the realest shit, man. Like, anybody before him, anybody after, nobody has come to his plateau. Nobody's ever touched his level. And then with him being the biggest selling rapper of all time, that's another stamp on his greatest of all time reputation.
Now, what is your goal in the music industry?
To be somebody well respected in the game, like I could go anywhere in the city, sell our shows. Everybody knows my name. Everybody knows my brand. Like some type of, like no limit type of success. You know what I mean? Like Master P, he got all the money, and because he went to school, he got his education coming from Conleon Projects, Third World, New Orleans, and him coming up from out of that and being to what he is today is very inspirational. So I want to be on his level. I want to live to see.
So you gotta go to school.
Yeah.
What school you want to go to and what you want to study?
Man, I want to go to JCSU. I want to study music business.
All right, go get your education while you're out there doing your thing. Let's talk about the single.
Mm-hmm. 1,000.
How did you come up with it? What was you doing? Where is all the creative juices? Let's go spill the beans, man.
Man, the concept has come from like being hot, just being hot, keeping it 1,000, always keeping it real with yourself. Like you don't gotta put on the front for nobody. And the heat that it's going to bring to the streets, 1,000, like, it's going to burn everything in the streets. Like, ain't nothing going to touch it. And then me being influenced by the Hot Boys growing up, you know, that's another influential.
Bout it. That's no limit, though. I know. I just, when you say Master P is one of the people you looked up to,
on the business side,
you want to put your business on, you know, it shows that, number one, you also studied.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of people don't study. They just get into it for the fame. They just want to be, they just want to have their name said by other people. You know what I mean?
So, yeah, but he worked hard to get where he was. It took a good minute to get No Limit to where they was.
See, but I look at it like a lot of people try to say, oh, I want to be like Diddy. I want to be like this one. Listen, Master P getting money in the cut.
Bro, and he don't be wanting to tell you how much he worth either. He don't. Like, if you used to bring up, like, I heard you got 350, he'd be like, man, go on with that. Like, he don't be wanting nobody to know, but everybody already know, like, man, No Limit was running shit. You still spending 1999 money, you know what I mean? So they was like, yeah.
So outside of music, what do you want to get into?
I want to give back to the community. Like, I want to be the voice for the voiceless, you know what I mean? After all the death that's going on and the kids, they got to have somebody to look up to. Like, I can't be a dude that's flashing guns all up in my video because I know the kids going to watch it. So they got to look up to somebody and say, okay, that's not right. And so I want to give back to the community, start some summer camps so we can get them out the street, have them something to do in the summer, after school programs, get them involved with activities that's away from the street so they don't have to be all in gangs and nothing, any kind of violence.
What does music mean to Malik Green?
Music means a lot because, like, I'm a music head. Like, I don't just study today's music. I love 90s music. And then I go back before that to see where they got their sound. Then I go back to the 70s. Then I go to the 60s. And because my mama, she's a old school head too. So I listen to a lot of old school music.
What song of music she be playing?
Luther Vandross, Gerald LaVert.
Boy.
R. Kelly.
Boy. Boy, you just named 3 R&B singers. Your mom love her R&B, huh?
Yeah, man. She danced. Her and my father, they danced Luther Vandross, Hendrick, Here and Now at their wedding. So that's one of my favorite songs.
Yeah. You had both your parents growing up?
Nah, my daddy, he's been locked up since I was like 1 year old.
Oh, wow, man.
Yeah.
But what is that like for you?
I mean, it was hard growing up without a father because I'm seeing everybody else with their dad, but it made me a strong person. It made me a good individual.
It makes you appreciate things at a lot younger age. You know what I mean? I could definitely speak because in my earlier years of life, it wasn't until recently that me and my father even became cool. You know what I mean? Where it was like, oh, what's up? You know, like, he came into my life about when I was like 14. Like, oh, I'm your dad. I'm like,
dang.
Word.
That's crazy.
There's a difference between a dad and a father. Yeah, you know what I mean? But
yeah.
I definitely could.
You might as well just call him. Sperm donor.
That was the joke growing up. You know what I mean? Like, oh, I don't got no dad. I had a sperm donor. You know what I mean? That was the joke growing up. But, you know, as I got older and as I started to understand things and, you know what I mean, understand that the situation really wasn't, he had to get his own self situated. He had to get his own self together. And when he got himself together, at least as a man, he approached me and said, listen, I know I wasn't your dad growing up.
Mm-hmm.
Even though I am your father, I've been there financially, whether it was child support, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, I want to try to be cool with you. I want to, and even to this day, you know what I mean? But I just want people out there to, even when they don't even have their dad around, you know, don't let it harbor you. Don't let it overshadow your thought. You know what I mean? I hate when people walk around and, you know, I think you can relate a lot more to it. Like when they see other people with their dad or whatnot around, you know, don't let it phase you. You know what I mean? It ain't your fault. Feel me? And I feel like people like us, even when we sit down with this plateau on interviews and whatnot, like that's something that I want people to take away from this. You know what I mean? Like in all my interviews, I want them to take away something from it.
In this particular
interview, I just want to focus on that, you know, because you can relate to it. You've been through it. You still going through it?
I'm past the I miss my daddy stage. I mean, I love him to death, but I'm past mama with my daddy coming home because, like, I'm grown now.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I'm not grown. I mean, I'm 18, but still.
Boy, you ain't grown.
I'm grown.
I can't say what I want to say.
I've been taking care of myself since I was, like, 16 years old, man. So, I mean, I feel grown. I don't really hang with people my age because, like, I feel like they too childish. I love older people. I love hanging around the older heads.
That's what you learn the most, man. Sitting around older people, you just sit back and be quiet and you just listen. And they pretty much tell you the blueprint, especially the people that love you and care about you. You know what I mean? They don't mind keeping it 100 with you. Like, they'll tell you if you don't stink. You know, if it stink, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
They tell you, like, hey, you need to chill out. You need to pull back. You know, what are some of the biggest influences outside of music? I know you said Tupac, but in your personal life, who are some of your biggest personal influences?
My mother, of course.
Why is that?
Because, like, she helps me with everything. Like, even, like, if I don't appreciate it, even if she know I don't deserve it, she'll still come through with whatever. Like, I love that lady. She's the bomb.
See, I call my mom my shero. You know what I mean? My mom the same
way. My mom my OG. And that's the name of my phone. Yeah, it's the OG.
Now, what's coming up next for you outside of this music thing? What's coming up next? What you want to do next with it?
I want to venture out into acting. Like, I want to get an audition for the Master P movie, King of the South, Ice Cream Man. Like, I was talking to the casting director. He was like, okay, you gonna have to pay this so we can get on the phone or whatever, like a consultant payment or whatever, and we'll talk about what you got to do, and I get you some more auditions along with that. And he was like, when we come to North Carolina, when we come to Georgia, and we just make sure you be there, because, like, we want to see you audition.
All right, so that's what's up. You got to get into acting.
I want to venture out to clothing too. I want to call it Bottom Dreams Clothing. Like, it's gonna have my logo, but that's how I'm gonna start off with it first.
So wait, Bottom Dreams? You're making like lingerie or something?
Nah. It's just like a symbol for anybody that want to come up from the bottom, and then they got dreams of coming up from the bottom. They want to get out that life that they're in right now, and they struggle, and they try to survive every single day. And Bottom Dreams is like being a rose that come from concrete. Like,
see, I'm glad you clarified that all up, because when someone first hear Bottom Dreams, they're like, ooh. But when you break it down and you explain it to people, I think that's
dope.
You
can really break it down. You can see it all in my logo. Like, you see a little boy kneeling down, and he sees a rose cracking through concrete, and it's coming up. And he's just looking at it like, wow, how's a rose cracking through concrete?
And you also did the music video. Was that your first music video?
Yeah, that was my first music video.
What was that feeling like for you?
I was nervous. Even Buck can tell you, he was guiding me on through, like, how you do this, how you do this, look at the camera, do this, get hype, all that other good stuff.
Well, man, Malik, it's a pleasure having you in the studio. It's a pleasure chopping it up with you. The single 1000 out right now. Make sure y'all watching that video. Tell them where to download it. Tell them your Instagram, Twitter, name, all that.
MalikGreen704 on my Instagram and Twitter. And just like my page on Facebook at Malik Green.
Yeah. Y'all keep it locked right here. Your boy Iron Tree Five. My dog Malik Green from the west side. One time for the south side though. Sharon Lakes, what up?
Boulevard home.
Buck TV. Y'all keep it locked right here. Come.